was for the proposition, and then I'm moving on to my positive case. So ladies and gentlemen, what has the proposition first talked about? Let's establish one thing. They first came up here and talked about basic needs and comfortable lives is something that the proposition will be deciding on their behalf, but they didn't set standards that what basis will be deciding on comfortable lives and to what extent will people be comfortable or what limit is there for it, and not and how they will be living luxurious ones. They don't get to decide who deserves what level of comfort is and what is luxurious for them or not, because that is something that will vary from each and every individual, and that is something that each and every individual decides on their own, and it's a preference for them that comes over the lifetime. The second thing to talk about, how this argument regarding the lottery of birth circled around the first, then the second speaker. How they were talking about that this lottery of birth was how rich people are given a silver spoon in their mouth. So what you're doing is you're talking about this lottery of birth for them and how you're leveling the pain by this policy that you're trying to implement. But what you're doing is that you're taking this privilege of being called rich or these rich people being credited of being rich from them. This is your definition of leveling the pain and deciding on a fair policy between them, but you're not doing that. You're decreasing their living standards and decreasing and not giving them the benefit of being rich, which I'll be talking about in my further positive case.
Ma'am,
I think we talked about how charity and taxation have played as a parallel policy. What my first speaker talked about was that this progressive tax system is an alternative present in the society that governments use in order to level this disparity and in order to make an equitable society. And it is a policy measure that is being implemented. Secondly, about corporate social responsibility, that these firms who are prospering and are earning billions of dollars, they contribute to the society and return that favor to them even though they don't have an obligation, but they take it as their responsibility and hence give them the benefit of their profits. Thirdly, we talked about how charities people donate and donate millions and millions of dollars. So what we talked about with these policies was that this was without compulsion. This was a right of choice that was granted to the people, and they took that liberty of making such a choice and hence providing the society with such benefits on their own. And that, ladies and gentlemen, does not require the proposition to impose such a moral responsibility on them. Thirdly, we were talking about how transgender biases exist and how self-evaluation of not being able, of individuals not being able to decide how who to give and who not to give. Well, firstly, people, if I'm a rich person, I don't have the responsibility to provide for everyone, and neither do I have the capacity to provide for everyone. Secondly, they talk about how these biases, if I want to give my wealth to someone, I give it to someone who I associate with and who I feel that I want to give it to. So when they talk about an evaluation measure, even if they bring this moral responsibility on them, they will need, even this evaluation will be needed for the people's behalf, because it's their money that's being taken away. So I'll be moving on to my positive case. In my positive case, I'll be talking about how communism as a medium has already implemented their moral responsibility policy that they are so fancy talking about, and how it has failed, and how capitalism is a beneficial measure in order to compensate for this alienation. So ladies and gentlemen, when I talk about how communism tried to achieve these same motives, I talk about Russia, how in Russia or any other communist country, where these basic needs were being met, how this motive of alleviating poverty was being carried out. But this didn't work, and I'll tell you why this wouldn't work, and I'll tell you why your policy wouldn't work. It wouldn't work because you're setting the wrong precedent for the people. You're telling the poor that the rich look after you, they will spoon feed you the money. One, we have two problems with that. One, the people will stop innovating, and two, how is this fair to the rich? So when I talk about how people will stop innovating, I talk about the part where an individual works hard their entire life, and they try to earn a career for themselves, make a living out of themselves, and they do it on their own basis. They are self-made people. When you get these poor the money from the rich, you're one
that
taking the privilege of taking this responsibility, this idea of making of being self-dependent and of creating a living for yourself from them. You're taking away this idea of being a certain individual from them. And this is something that every single individual should have a motive towards in their life. Because when you take away this, you're actually putting them on a dependency cycle, a dependency on the rich, that they will always need the rich to back up for them, to have the rich to hang up, support them, and hence they won't make a living out, living for themselves. And it is the burden, and it becomes the burden of the rich to take on their heads. Now, I'll tell you why it isn't fair to the rich. One, Sarah talked about the brain drain because it will eventually harm the economy. But firstly, why isn't it fair to the rich? Because one, now you don't get to enjoy the perks of being rich. I earned a hard living in my entire life. At the end of the day, if I can't enjoy that privilege of being rich and all that luxury of earning such hard money, then what is the point of me being rich? I'm better off poor because I know that the poor will support me and I will not need to have made such a sacrifice my entire life and have to make a self-living out of myself. Because if at the end of the day, the poor are being made better off and we are achieving the same standards for them, then that doesn't give me any perk or any benefit because at the end of the day, I'm just like them or we become as equitable and the hard work and hard work and education and everything I spend on it just goes to them and that becomes unfair to me because I don't get to enjoy what I've earned and I don't have the privilege of being rich anymore. And they need to tell us that why they are not better and they need to tell us that how the burden falls on them, that why am I not better off poor? Because if I get rich, if I'm rich and
what about the people on the other side of the city living in slums?
When we're talking about alleviating them from poverty and the mechanism, we don't have a problem. We know that they are poor, but the mechanism that you're trying to implement, that is what we have a problem with. If I'm talking about how it falls on the government and how it's their responsibility in order to take care of everything. So, how much time do we have?
45 seconds.
So, I'll tell you about how this entire responsibility falls on the government. One, when you shove this responsibility on the rich, you take the government out of this blame game. Because it is, at the end of the day, the government to blame. Because one, they have failed to alleviate poverty themselves. And two, they have failed to provide them with facilities like health and education and proper conditions to live. So even if you take this decision of alleviating poverty by the help of the rich, one, it will be a short-term solution, and two, it won't work in the long term. Because when you create this dependency cycle, at the end of the day, generations will go on and the cycle will continue where people will start, where people will be at the one level of poverty, or level up maybe. But the point will be that at the end of the day, you're pushing, the consequence of this would be that you're pushing your rich people out of your country, as brain drain Sarah talked about, and how you're not giving them poor a stepping stone to work their way out of this mess, and how you're putting them in a dependency cycle is a worse off situation.